Welcome back, everyone. This is video three for chapter seven, sedimentary rocks. Let's continue our discussion with the different types of sedimentary rocks and their associated textures. So there are two major groups. We have our detrital rocks we previously discussed. All detrital sedimentary rocks have clastic textures. That means that they are composed of discrete fragments cemented together, whether the fragment be clay, silt, sand, or gravel. Chemical and organic sedimentary rocks can have non-clastic, or what we call crystalline textures, as well as clastic textures. The crystalline texture, there is a pattern of interlocking crystals. This table for the classification of sedimentary rocks says it all. We have our detrital rocks here. It shows you the different size particles, the sediment name, and the rock name. Notice that all detrital rocks have the clastic texture. Chemical and organic sedimentary rocks are broken up here based on their chemical composition. And you notice that some of these rocks have crystalline or non-clastic textures, while others have clastic. This is a good table to review and become familiar with the various sedimentary rocks and their textures. What do you think? Clastic or non-clastic texture? If you look at this close-up, you can see the interlocking grains. That tells you that it is a non-clastic texture, and in fact, this is rock salt. Sedimentary rocks tell us about the environment that existed in the geologic past. The term environment of deposition or sedimentary environment is simply an area where sediment gets deposited. We have three broad categories of environments: the continents, the oceans or marine, and then that area between the marine and continental environments we'll refer to as transitional. Starting with our continental depositional environments, it's really dominated by stream erosion and deposition. We can also have glacial deposits and wind-blown deposits, what are referred to as aeolian. The marine environment entails shallow marine and deep marine. Shallow marine is defined as water to about a depth of 200 meters, so it is bordering the continental land surface. Large amounts of sediment from the land accumulates. Seaward of the shallow marine, we get more fine-grained sediment because the turbulence of the water decreases as you get away from the shoreline. Another feature of the deep marine environment are called turbidity currents, which are just underwater landslides. And that would be an exception of a situation where you won't just get fine sediments, but these turbidity currents also deposit coarse sediments. Finally, we can talk about the transitional environments. Those are the environments between the marine and the continental environments, such as beaches, tidal flats, spits, lagoons, and deltas. Spend some time reviewing this diagram, as it is an overview of various sedimentary environments. Different sediments can be deposited right next to each other and be the same age. The reason this happens is that the environmental conditions are changing, and we call that a facies. An example of sedimentary facies: if you were on the beach and you walked out into the water, the first facies you would enter is the sandstone facies, consisting of sand-sized particles which are coarse and fall out of the water first. Then there would be a transition into finer grain material, such as clay, which would eventually become a shale facies. Further offshore, but still in the shallow marine environment, you get your limestone facies. So all of these sediments, which eventually became sedimentary rocks, were being deposited at the same time, but they are different because we are going from near shore environments to offshore. So when you think of facies, I want you to think of, it tells me about the depositional environment. Additional information with regard to Earth's history includes the study of sedimentary structures. Let's look at some of these structures. The first one are strata, which just means a rock layer or a bed of rock. Bedding planes are the breaks between the strata. Crossbedding is another sedimentary structure where the sedimentary layers are inclined. I'll show you a visual of this. We find crossbedding in sand dunes, deltas, and some stream deposits. This is a diagram showing strata, a bed, and then separating the bed are the bedding surfaces here. All they are is a representation of where sedimentation stopped, material stopped being deposited for whatever reason, and then it started back up. So you get these bedding planes separating your beds or your strata. These are cross beds, the inclined layers, and cross beds can form in a desert, for example. So here is a sand dune exhibiting cross beds, and we can interpret the direction of the current. In this case, wind would be the current. So this top layer here, the wind was going this way. That's not a very good arrow. Another sedimentary structure are graded beds. These are primarily found out in the deep ocean as a result of a turbidity current flowing down the canyon and depositing out the heaviest material first and then finer material on top. So we grade from coarse to fine as you progress up in a graded bed. Three additional structures include ripple marks. These are small waves that are lithified in the rock. Mud cracks indicate an environment that gets wet and dry. And fossils are sedimentary structures that tell us about depositional environment as well. Picture A shows ripple marks. B is a mud cracks. This concludes our video for Chapter 7, Video 3, and our next unit will be Metamorphic Rocks.